Well, hello my beauties and welcome to my channel. Today, three looks, one palette using the Disco Queen palette. Is it shiny? It's okay. Using the Disco Queen palette by Exposed Cosmetics. So, if you want to know what three looks I have created with this palette, then just keep on watching. Guys, another three looks, one palette, and as I mentioned in a few other videos, but maybe you haven't seen them yet, instead of doing five looks with a bigger palette, I am sticking to three. It will save me a lot of time filming and editing, and it will just make the video shorter, and I will be able to show you more of the application than if I put five looks in one video. So that was a little household message. This is what the palette looks like, and if you want me to do looks that I didn't do in this video, let me know down in the comment section and I will do that for you. The look I have on now is the last look. I did a review on this palette that went up yesterday. I will link it underneath the cards. I will also link my three or four the dot 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 looks with one palette, because sometimes it was three, sometimes it was five. I will link that underneath the cards as well. I will also link underneath the cards a playlist that I made on my channel with some of the videos by my sisters in the Beauty YouTubers Growth group. All their channels are listed down in the description box. But I also made a playlist that you can find underneath the cards and also in my description box. And yeah, that was about it. Let's just get started with the rest of the video and get ready for look number one. So look number one with the Disco Queen palette by Exposed Cosmetics. I have already applied my foundation. I have primed my eyes and everything. Yeah, we have five mattes in this palette. We have the black matte and then these are all mattes as well. And let's start with this one. So I'm taking my fluffy brush, not the biggest I have, but a little bit smaller. I haven't set my base as, well, usually I don't. So I'm just going to tap this yellow color on as a transition shade. So now that we are all zoomed in, I'm going to, well, go on with what I was doing. So I'm taking the yellow matte of this palette on a brush and I am just going to tap that on my eye. And now that my base is set a little bit, and now I can gently, well, gently just go on blending and just, you know, lay down as much pigment as I want. I can nicely build this yellow up, no problem. If you're having trouble blending these out, go watch my Hasina 2 review. There I will give you some tips on how to work with shadows that are opposite your skin tone. So I'm just really building up the yellow color. So, my yellow base is on. I want to bring it underneath my eye as well. So let's get small fluffy brush into the yellow color, and I don't mind that it is lower. If you do, then just take like a pencil brush or something that you can control a little bit easier. Okay, that is number one. Now I know that you can put shimmers in your crease, and let's try that just for funsies. So I'm going to take this color, that's a shimmery orange, and let's see how it wants to blend. Shimmer shades are not meant to be blended out, just so you know. They are meant to be packed on. It seems to be blending out fine. Let's do the other eye. Hmm. It's a little bit too light for what I am going for. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go in with this brown color. I'm going to use that to deepen up this part. And it plays nicely with the rest of the shade, so that's nice. It's not very pigmented, this palette, but that's okay too. It actually makes it more user friendly, because if it's not really really pigmented, like in your face pigmented, you can be a bit more bold, you know. You can just easily build up colors and have fun with color instead of having it be in your face, if you know what I mean. I don't mind it being in your face, but some people do. I have played with these shadows. You don't need a sponge tip with this palette specifically, but I just prefer using sponge tips with shimmer shades. You can use your fingers, you can do anything you want really, but I prefer a sponge tip. I'm going to go into this orange, the one that I put in my crease, with my sponge tip. I'm going to plop that here. Now I'm going to go into this neon yellow shimmer and see what that does. It's a very pretty color though. Yes, that is very pretty. I do want a little bit of depth, to be honest, on my outer corner. I'm taking a small detail brush and I'm going to go into this pretty red shimmer. And I'm just going to deepen up the outer part of my eye a little bit, just to warm the look up. I also want it a little bit up. Yes, that's pretty. Let's take a brush and see if we can fade it out a little bit. Now, this red is a shimmer shade. It does want to blend out, but it's going to take a little bit of time. And because it is on top of other shades, it's actually easier. Oh, this goes actually pretty well today, so that's nice. Okay, let's take this brush and a little bit of that orangey shimmer again. Let's put that over here. Because I don't want it to be yellow, red. I want it to be a bit deeper orange, if I can make that happen. Let's take a bit of the neon yellow, the same brush. That's pretty, that's pretty, pretty, pretty. With the rest that I have on my brush, I'm just going to go over this a little. And there. Okay, let's try and recreate the same thing on the bottom. I am going to do something different actually. I'm going to take my small detail brush in the orangey shimmer color, this one, and let's run that a little bit higher than the yellow I put down, but still quite low. Yes, now let's take a flat brush. So I have a flat brush and let's go into the red, the shimmery red, and let's put that close to the lash line. That's pretty. I want to bring that up a little bit, so I'm taking a pencil brush with the tip in that shimmery red that I just used, and a tiny bit here, just in the outer corner. Just a little sneak peek of that red. I like that. Yuki. For highlight, let's use this one. This it's also a shimmer. Oh, my pencil brush. And let's plop that here. And you know what? Let's for funsies bring it up a little. And down. What I do want to do, to be totally honest with you, pencil brush. And then the neon yellow on the tip, and plop that somewhere on my bottom lash line as well. Actually a little bit underneath. And let's smoke that out a bit. I kind of like messy shadow looks, but yeah. Oh, I forgot something. Let's take that does not matter. What do I have here? I have a flat eyeshadow brush. Let's go into this color, the very, very, what is it? very, very pale yellow. And let's plop that here. It just cleans up the look a little bit and it keeps with the yellow theme, so I like them. I like that. I'm getting a cold, so sorry if I'm touching my nose. I am going to do so I'm doing eyeliner, I am doing a mascara, and I will figure out a lipstick. Then I will be back and show you the look before I put on my falsies. So hold on tight, I'll be right back. So this is actually the finished look. I have decided to not wear my falsies because it is so windy outside that I'm afraid that they will blow off. So this is going to be the finished look. I applied mascara. What I did actually is I plopped from Revolution, what is it? It's a lip pencil in the color Regal. I plopped that in my inner waterline and on top as eyeliner. Then I tight lined with some liquid, with this one from Maybelline. It's just a black eyeliner gel pot thingy. And I put mascara on. Oh, my nose is itchy. The mascara I put on is the Lash Princess from Essence. And the lips, lipstick I used is, I used this pencil as well. And then I used the Revolution liquid lipstick in Regal. It came in a lip set. So yeah, I like how it turned out. This was look number one using the Disco Queen palette from Exposed Cosmetics. Get ready for look number two. So look number two with the Disco Queen palette, and I thought let's see if we can make a pinkish red look or something today. I am starting off with a fluffy brush and the very, very pale yellow. Why? Because I only have a few mattes and I want to blend a shimmer shade and I want to give it some help. So I'm just laying down the very, very pale yellow. It will not show up, at least I don't expect it to, but that is actually what I want. Make sure that the base is set with the shadow. What I could try is, let's try this one. Maybe I'm biting myself in the foot now because it's a very cool tone shadow, because it's a gray, but let's see what it does. I don't feel that the gray is really showing up, so let's go to a smaller brush. Let's do what I told you to do with the Hasina 2. Let's build the gray up. So I'm taking a slightly smaller brush and I'm building the gray up. I don't know if it will show up, but we will see. Actually swirling my brush in pretty heavy-handedly because it doesn't really show up. I can see it a little. And I don't think that I really need to blend this color out because it is so light. So I'm actually just laying it down, building it up. So I think it's not really showing up, I feel, but okay. Let's take the same brush that I used. I'm cleaning it off and I'm going to go into this color. Now it's a shimmer. So let's start slow. It's a shimmer. I'm going to plop that here. And you can put shimmers in your crease, no problem. If you use a fluffy brush, it won't be as shimmery, but just remember that a shimmer is not meant to blend out. Some shimmers you can blend out, no problem. Others take a little bit of more work. But because I already laid down two eyeshadows, it should have something to slip over, if you get my meaning. So I'm actually just dipping my brush in and then placing the shadow where I want it and then gently fading it out. So I'm not trying to blend too much. I'm kind of working this like I would a cool toned shadow. So I'm laying it down, fading it out just a little, and I'm actually slowly building up the color to again help myself with blending. And I think that's doing very, very well. If I look in the mirror, Oh, I don't have my lenses in because I didn't feel like it, but it doesn't look patchy. You can see a little bit of shimmer and the texture of my eye. That is the trouble with shimmers. If you put anything shiny on top of something that is textured, it can enhance the texture. Just so you know, I don't care. I don't care. But just so you know. So if you don't want that, then don't put something with a little bit of shimmer on top of something with texture. But you know, it's the same thing that we do with highlighter. If I do this, I have smile lines here, but I also place my highlighter here, and I don't care. I want to bring the shadow up a little higher, because if I look forward, you can see the pink here, but it kind of gets lost in the hood of my eye, so I'm looking down a little bit, bringing it a little bit higher in the middle, so that when I look forward now on this eye, you can see the pink. And that is what I want. It's kind of the same color as my shirt, so... Do I have fallout? No, you can have fallout if you try to blend out a shimmer shade, just so you know. Let's go to the next color. I'm getting a smaller brush, and I think... You know what? Let's just go for this one. This is a red with more pink in it than blue, if that makes sense. So I'm using a smaller brush and I'm tapping it off. I'm looking down because I want this shadow to be lower, and again, this is also a shimmer shade, so it's going to take me a little bit more work to blend it out. Probably it's actually doing okay. Wow, did I ever mention that this was a 10-pound palette? So it was £9.99. I think I paid 11 euros for it or something. So just so you know. And this one is a little bit more shimmery than the last one. Let me see. I want it up a little bit higher in the middle. Tiny bit more on this side, and then I'm going to blend it out. So now I'm actually cleaning my brush. And I'm going to go with the same brush over the edge to fade it into the lighter pink. And what I can always do is bring a little bit of the lighter pink back. So let's just do that. I'm tapping my brush in to the lighter pink, this one. And I am actually using that to blend it into each other. So we have a little bit more of a gradient effect. And again, can you see that? Yeah. I'm holding the brush quite low. And I'm not putting a lot of pressure on my eye. Ooh, that's pretty. Look how pretty. So I'm going to go over this side first, blend the edge a little. Then I'm taking the lighter pink, just dabbing my brush in and going over the edge. Let's see if they are even. They are. And I know I'm missing a bit here and here, but that does not matter. It will work out. Okay, I like this. What I'm going to do now is take this one. This is a red shimmer. And you know, let's just use the same brush. It doesn't matter. I'm going in, I'm going to put that even lower. You know what? Let's take a sponge tip and put that, the red that I just showed you, on the lid. I could use a brush, but I still prefer sponge tips with shimmers on my lid. So I'm actually putting it all over my lid. I think that's pretty. That's pretty. Okay, what I'm going to do is with the clean side of my sponge tip go back into this color, the more pinkish red, and let's plop that here on the outer corner. And now you can see, because I'm using a sponge tip, it's way more vibrant and dark than when I used the brush. So let's see if we can build up the darker. Let's put the red a little bit higher. This brush, and I'm going into the red that I put on my lid, and I'm just going to fade that out here, low in the crease, very low. Like that. Okay. I want to what do I want to do with the bottom? Let me just put a little bit of that red shimmer that I put on the lid on a small detail brush and just kind of connect it here to the inner, or no, outer part of my bottom eyelid, if that makes sense. I think that's a bit better. Let me clean it up a little. Yes, then I'm going back with my small brush and just kind of do this. I personally am not a fan of sharp lines on me, but I do want the shadow to go up, so that is why I'm kind of doing what I did. What do I want with the bottom? Let's take the detail brush. I cleaned it. Let's go into this green and plop that on the bottom. Again, I don't know if I will like it. If I don't, I will take it off. I don't like that. Aww. Okay, so what am I going to do now? I'm going to go with the same brush into this color. Plop that here. Okay, I'm making a mess. Let's take this blue and see what that does. Ah, that's better, I think. I think that's fun, I think. Let's bring the blue up a little higher. Okay. I'm cleaning off the small brush again, because we need an inner corner highlight. The obvious choice would be the white, but you know what? Let's take orange. So I'm going into this. And I like to bring the shadow up a little. I don't know, I feel like that ties it more together. Huh, fun. Yeah, fun. Okay. I'm going to add a little liner. Like so. I'm getting a very, very small brush and a gel liner. And I'm going to tight line with that. Why is one always thicker than the other? Why? Let's put a little bit here. No, let's not. Okay, so tight line is just from Maybelline. It's just a black gel liner. This one is from Revolution. It's their Renaissance Flick. Let's add some mascara. The Essence Lash Princess, the purple one I have here. This is the look with mascara and liner. I'm going to go off camera, put on my falsies and a little lipstick, and then I will be right back and you will see the finished result. So this is the finished look with my lashes and my lipstick. I was feeling dramatic, so I did dramatic eyelashes. The lashes I have on are from Sosu, from the Primark, in the style Milan. And the lipstick I'm wearing is Clinique's Pop Matte Graffiti Pop. That's the one. I think it turned out really, really fun. And yeah, guys, let's get ready for look number 3, which is also the last look. So, the last look with the Disco Queen palette from Exposed Cosmetics. Let's just go have fun. Let me zoom you in a little. I haven't set my base, but what I am going to do is lay down a color first. And let's use this one, because I haven't used that one as well. I don't want a heavy layer, so I'm picking a very fluffy brush like that. And I'm going to go into the matte brown. So this one. And let's use that as a transition shade. And again, because I haven't set my base, I'm tapping the color on first. I do have a self-setting foundation on my eyes, because I only used primer low. And that is all I want. So it's a very light layer. Let me see. It is pretty light. If you are a deeper skin tone than me, you could use this to set your base. actually what I'm doing now. So first color is down, let's go to the next. So I'm taking a smaller fluffy brush. Let's use this one. So it's a little bit, it's not really a neon green, but kind of close. And let's use that here. And what I want to show you with this palette is that yes, you can put shimmers in your crease or as a transition shade. And I know a lot of people say that you cannot, but you can. And that is what I want to show you. And you don't have to be scared for that. But you know, what you could always do is if you think it's a little bit too shiny, I think you can do the same thing that you do with your foundation. So take a beauty blender, pat over it. You could try that. You could try after that putting some translucent mattifying powder on top. And you know, you don't have to stick to one palette. I know that's a trend, and I know a lot of people want that, and when I'm in a hurry I like to just get one palette and create my look, but I don't mind grabbing other palettes to create looks. I don't mind that at all. It's a very pretty minty green when you put it on your eye. It's very, very fun, cheery color. And now I'm going to blend it out. So I'm taking a small brush, make sure it's clean, and then just go over the edges. And again, if you feel that you need help, just get a little bit of the first color you put down. And if there is not a light enough color for you that you want to use in the palette, then just grab some face powder. And if you really want to create a neutral crease, and you only have a colorful palette, I'm dipping back into the green that I used. Just get a bronzer or a blush. They work great on the eye as well. The only thing that doesn't really work as an eyeshadow is a pressed highlighter, just so you know. But then again, maybe it depends on the highlighter. I don't know. I think that's pretty. Oh, I think that's nice. Let me put it up a little higher, and I maybe even need to dip into another color later, but I will see that later. Let's go for the dark green first, and let's plop that same small brush in the crease. And you know, for the price of this palette and the fact that I am blending out shimmer shades, I am very, very impressed. Oh, it's pretty. It's turning a bit of a bluish. Now you can see that this one is a bit more shimmery than the last one. And that could also be because I put two shimmers on top of each other. It could be. Again, I don't mind. I think this is kind of fun. The only weird thing is it looks like it's turning blue instead of green, which is strange. Oh no. If I am up close in the mirror, I can see that it is green, but it's turning a kind of aqua, which is strange. It's fun, but it is strange. Let's take a little bit of the black, just a little. I'm just dabbing my brush in lightly, and let's plop that over here to deepen it up a little. Ooh, it's a bit darker than I was going for, to be honest. So I'm just lightly tapping my brush in the black, but probably because I use the shimmer shade. Shimmer shades are kind of slippery, or at least that's how I feel now I'm blending the black over it. So that's probably why I don't need as much. And let's just have fun. Let's go with the dark blue, that one. Now I'm actually just plopping colors on that I haven't used before. Let's plop that here, and also in the crease, because what is weird, it could be my lighting, but The weird part is that it looked like the green that I put on my eye turned to bluish. Could be my undertone. That it's pulling more to the yellow side of the green instead of the blue. I don't know. Okay, I also haven't used this one and this one. So let's start with this one. Okay, I want a different brush. Let me get packing brush. Why is this turning purple? Ah, there's the color. Maybe I had a little bit of blue on my brush. Let's bring it in a little bit more. I'm also tapping it over the blue here, so it's actually not that strange that it is getting a different color. I'm using these shadows dry, just so you know. The shimmer is fantastic if you use the right brush. And I can still see that my crease is shimmery as well. But again, I don't mind that. Do I have fallout? Yes, a little. Yes, let's use a detailed brush. I clean it off. Let's go into this salmon-y color, and I'm using a tiny brush for that. Okay, I'm going to spray that. Maybe I should have cut the crease, but I just don't feel like it today. Oh, I think that's pretty. Okay. Oh yeah, let's spray it again. Yeah, that's nice. Okay, I'm cleaning off the brush and I'm just going to go over the edge here. And what you can do is get a little bit of this one, the one I used on the outside of my eye, just a little bit in the center to help blend the two colors together. And maybe a little bit more peachy. That's pretty. Let's bring that peachy color in as well, like a thaw. And let's use this dark purple that I haven't used. Can you see? Yeah, that I haven't used yet. Let's use that on the lower waterline, because we can. So I'm using the same detail brush. I just cleaned it off. I'm going to spray it again, like so. I also want to connect it up just a little. I don't know, I feel like if I stop in my outer corner, I'm missing a piece or something. I'm just bringing it a little bit up in the outer corner of my eye, just a little. And we're going to do the same thing on the other eye. I think that's fine. I think it is. What I am going to do, This is, I think, the second brush I used. I'm going to go back into the first color, that one. I'm taking it a little bit higher. And what I'm going to do now, I want to use this one, the yellow. I just cleaned the brush. And then I'm going to go over the edge. I need a different brush, of course I do. Taking the small brush into the same matte yellow. I'm going to go over the edge here. I'm just going to blend this together a little bit. I think that's nice. Okay, other side. Let me take the same brush, clean it, going back into that darker green. And just bring it up a little bit more. And I do have to say, I think it's weird that the green isn't green, or at least not in my lighting. Maybe that's it as well. Going back in the yellow, the matte yellow. Huh, I like that. I kind of like that. I have mermaid eyes. Let's go back into the dark blue. Dark blue shimmer with this brush. And let's deepen up the crease a little bit more. And I don't really mind that it gets lost. You can see it peeking through a little, but when I look down, you can see the gradient, and I like that. I think that's pretty. Yes, I think I do. What I do want to do is just take a pencil brush and just dip the tip into the dark blue and just connect it a little bit here. Just a little. Just to bring it around the eye a bit. Yes, I like that. Okay. Cleaning up the pencil brush. Smoking it out a little, or at least connecting these two colors. I think that is pretty. Now, let us plop just your standard highlighter in the tear duct, that one, the white one, like so. If you wanted to, you could add a little highlighter here. I'm not usually a big fan, but okay. I don't have anything extra on my brush. I'm just swiping on what I have left on it, like so. I think that's very, very pretty. Let me plop on a little eyeliner. And if you wanted to, you could use a blue eyeliner as well. I'm just going to use a black. You can use any color that you want. So, eyeliner is on, pretty close to the lashes. I am going to tightline, however. So I'm just taking an angled brush and gel eyeliner, because that's the only thing that stays on when I am wearing my lashes. And I'm just going to plop that on the top part of the waterline. Yes. Okay, this is just one from Maybelline. Oh, and this one, the eyeliner, is from Revolution. It's their Renaissance Flick, and it's fantastic. Let's plop on some mascara real quick. This is the Essence Lash Princess in the with the purple things. And let's just... If you want to, you can add mascara to your bottom lashes. I'm not going to. My bottom lashes are pretty long, so they look like spider legs. At least I think so when I put mascara on the bottom. What I'm going to do off camera is apply bronzer, blush, lipstick, and falsies. And then I will be back and show you the finished result. So here is the finished look with everything on. And I thought, let's get a little bit dramatic, hence the dramatic eyelashes. These are from Sosu, and you can get them at Primark. I have the style Milan. The lippy is Catrice Velvet Matte in 20. This concludes our 3-look-1 palette using the Disco Queen palette from Exposed Cosmetics. Let me know what you think about the video. If you liked it, give it a thumbs up. Let me know down in the comment section what your favorite look was. And if you have this palette, if you want to get the palette, and if you want me to recreate a look, well, with this palette, a look that I haven't done yet, let me know down in the comment section below. Also, don't forget to check out my description box for the channels of my sisters in the Beauty YouTubers Growth group. We also have a playlist, or at least I made a playlist on my channel with some of their videos in it, which will be linked down below and underneath the cards. So go check it out. If you like them, hit their subscribe button. And while you're at it, also hit my subscribe button. And then just, you know, because you are clicking buttons anyway, just hit my notification bell. Doesn't seem to be working, but well, then you know that you have done everything you possibly can to get notified when I upload my next video, which will be tomorrow. So yeah, I am signing off. I'm wishing you all a great day, and I hope to see you in my next one. Bye, guys.